We have these training prayers in Nigeria. Ladies, may your saga locate you. Every lady wants a saga to locate her. We know what's happening in the Big Brother Niger house, the Big Brother Niger season 6, the Shine Your Eye edition. Between Saga and Nini, they are madly in love. But all, do I say with each other? No, I think Saga is madly in love with Nini. But fine, Nini loves Saga because we saw her kissing and pecking Saga. But according to Nini, she says she has a boyfriend outside the house. But I mean, the love between Saga and Nini is growing stronger by the day in the house. We knew what happened during the week when Big Brother gave Nini a task that she should hide in a secret room where nobody will discover. And she left around 12 a.m. in the middle of the night. She went in there, stayed there for like 24 hours. It wasn't easy for the housemate, especially Saga. Saga was just confused. He was searching for Nini everywhere, under the carpet, under... It was fun anywhere. It was funny. But fine, Big Brother brought up that idea because people have been complaining that this house is boring, that the housemates are boring. But that this week, we had fun in the show because of what Big Brother decided to do between the love circle that is building around Nini and Saga. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and humbly welcome to the Greatest Doctor Temi. He will give you hundreds of trending issues in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. Please, if you are new now, it's worth the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like, so as to stay updated whenever I upload new content. We're still talking about the drama that's happening in the house between Saga and Nini when Big Brother asked Nini to leave the house for like 24 hours, for like a day. It wasn't easy for people in the house and those outside, especially Saga's sister. Saga's sister came up online and dropped a message. According to her, she said she never expected Big Brother to be this insensitive. Wow, that came from the desk of Saga's sister. She said, "This actually made me really sad. Given the KV situation, I never expected at Big Brother Niger to be this insensitive. People are legit worried. You are playing with people's mental health for entertainment and sport." Wow. In other words, she wasn't happy with what Big Brother did by taking her brother's lover, Nini, out of the house for 24 hours. According to her, she was developing fear that maybe Saga will now develop mental issues. What do you think about that? Yeah, she was actually referring to the KV situation because KV went to the house and he left after a few days because he had this mental problem. Are you really entertained? For those that are following the Big Brother Niger show back to back, are you really entertained? Are these housemates really giving you the vibe you expected? Because when they were coming to the house, they promised us vibe that this will tell you I'm a fashion designer, I am here to entertain people. Are they really entertaining us? You know, and so many persons have been complaining regarding Liquor Rose, that Liquor Rose says she's a dancer. Yeah, we've known her as a dancer, but is she really giving us the vibe since she went into the Big Brother Niger? And she has a huge number of fans out there who are supporting her because of what they saw, you know, on her IG page. And her IG page or followers grew from thousands to millions in just a short span. Is Liquor Rose really a good dancer in the house? Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Regarding the drama that happened to the house where Big Brother asked Nini to vacate the house, to leave the house, yeah, the main house, though she was still in the building. Though Saga's sister wasn't satisfied with the decision Big Brother took. We have this message from our favorite online doctor. You know, this guy has been dropping messages on Twitter. He tweets a lot. Well, he's an online doctor, according to him. He said, "Anyone with a brain in a game show should know Nini is definitely not dead. Not kidnapped and not killed. At best, it's a task she's doing. At worst, it's just Biggie's plan. She's definitely fine. Saga tears is not from a place of love. It is from a place of deep foolishness." Wow. That Saga, yeah, when Nini left the house, Saga woke up and he after searching for Nini everywhere, he didn't see Nini. He was shedding tears. But to everybody's surprise, I mean, a few minutes after shedding tears, they brought food for him. The guy entered the food. He was just eating the food as if he hasn't eaten for years. And according to our favorite online doctor, he has just dropped his own comments that it was just a game. This is a game. This Big Brother house, they went into the house knowing that, fine, we are going into this house to play a game. That is a game. And fine, Big Brother is like the final referee. Yeah. He makes the final decision. So, what do you really think about what happened to the Big Brother house between Saga and Nini, where Big Brother asks needed to vacate the premises for some time. Are you in support of Saga Sister, or are you in support of our favorite online doctor? Please don't forget to drop your comments on the comment section below. And also, I've dropped so many videos on what happened in the house, of the drama that happened when Nini left the house, and when they were searching for her, and when she finally came back into the house. Well, as I said, Nini told Saga she has a boyfriend outside the house. Though Saga has been pushing, he has been playing his best game to make sure he wins Nini's heart. And regarding what happened, the game plan Big Brother brought in, so many persons felt, okay, Saga will be just like, please, I can't do this again. I can't stay without Nini in the house. But I think he would have done that if he had stayed for more than 24 hours. He waited for 24 hours, though he was asleep when Nini came in. And it was Pere that saw Nini coming in, and he had to wake Saga up from the sleep. Saga went in, met Nini, and he was just crossing his hand. And since then, Saga hasn't, I mean, left Nini sleeping alone. He will always be there. Most times, he will open his eyes to watch Nini so that Nini will not disappear again, as it happened. Well, regarding what Nini said, that she has a boyfriend, people have been asking, who is this boyfriend? Finally, we've seen the boyfriend. This is Nini and her boyfriend. Wow. So Nini's boyfriend has been found. Regarding Nini's boyfriend, someone dropped a message that Nini doesn't have any boyfriend anywhere. Forget that lie. As a matter of fact, she loves Saga, but she doesn't want to give you guys highlights on national TV. Why hasn't the boyfriend showed up on the internet since? Fact is, Nina is either in a one-sided relationship or she is dating a ghost, period. Do you really think Nini is, I mean, reciprocating the love Saga is showing to her? Or is it that the love is one-sided? It's just coming from Saga's side and not from Nini's side? Because that's what so many persons have been saying, that Saga is not in love with Nini, but Nini is not that in love with Saga the way Saga is in love with her. What do you think about that? Please don't forget to drop your comments on the comment section below. Yeah, let's move on to something else. You know, there's this that has been trending online about a girl, a hawker, who, I mean, she has this angelic voice. She sings very well. And we shouldn't forget the power of the internet. Nigerians are not really happy with what the president or the current administration did, those in the presidential circle did, by banning Twitter for more than 100 days. And we've lost millions of, do I say millions? Billions of naira since Twitter banned for more than 100 days. And according to online, Muhammad said that it will come back very soon. But how soon? They didn't give us a date. They just said it will come back very soon. All because Twitter deleted a tweet or two tweets from Mr. President. I mean, from one man, we've lost millions of or billions of naira, and we are still collecting loan. Well, some persons are basically in support of what is happening, some persons are not. Whatever I think, please don't forget to drop a comment below. Well, see, regarding the power of social media, we know so many persons out there met the love of their life via social media, via Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat. I mean, yeah, we have so many marriages where at the end of the day, if you ask them, how did you guys meet? They'll say, okay, we met online. Well, regarding that, this girl just blew. She just blew. According to reports, we got a report from Sally Music herself that I got a call from Rihanna. You can imagine Rihanna calling her a hawker in Nigeria. Wow. That is superb. That is sweet. That is very, very sweet. And also, Christian Amanpour. We know Christiana Amanpour. She has been an anchor on one of the largest TV networks in the world, CNN, for years. She doesn't interview kids. I mean, yeah, not that she doesn't interview kids. She interviewed, as in, people that are made or that are in the process of being made. She interviewed presidents, prime ministers. I mean, what does governors? No, governors are even low. Yeah, she interviews kings. She is, I mean, a superb anchor. We got this report from the desk of Christiana Amanpour that, Sally, you are a star and an inspiration to many all over the world. Will you kindly accept an invitation to tell your story on my show? You can imagine Amanpour begging Sally to please accept her invitation to tell her story on her show, on her CNN show. This girl don't blow. This girl don't blow. I mean, she has made it. Sally is made. That is the truth, whether I like it or not. And that is the power of social media. I think This government should try their possible best to bring back Twitter, because we are missing Twitter in this country. Seriously, we are really missing Twitter. Fine, everything has its pros and cons. There are bad sides of social media. There are also good sides of social media. But with our economy and what is going on, we really need this social media to keep us going, because we don't have jobs in this country. And so many persons are using this social media to make a living. They should bring back Twitter. What do you think about that? Don't forget to drop a comment below. We're still talking about Rihanna. We know recently Rihanna came up and said her mom or her grandma told her her origin, that she originated from Igbo in Nigeria. And we know Rihanna is now a billionaire. Her Fenty's, I mean, clothing line has been selling. She's been doing very well. We've always known Rihanna as a good musician. She's been dropping hits back to back, and she kind of diverted into clothing, and she's been making money. Still talking about Rihanna, our sister Rihanna, who's from Igbo, we have this good news that Thames meets Rihanna. And Rihanna was telling Thames how big the Essence song is. Thames don't blow. I mean, that song she did with Wizkid, Essence, she did very well. And according to Thames, she said she went through visiting all the record labels in Nigeria, begging them to sign her. They were like, no, this is your sound, it doesn't make sense, it won't sell. But look at Thames right now. That's why it's always good to believe in yourself. It's just imagine Sally, Christiana Amanpo, asking her to come to her show. I mean, even pleading with her. I mean, sometimes in life, you don't just need to hustle. I mean, good luck will just locate you. It will locate you wherever you are. That's one good thing. Look at Thames. She has blown just by doing that song. She's been singing fine. She's been hustling, doing her own songs. But she just did a song with Wizkid, Essence. And because of that, Drake had to feature her on the song Fountains in his album Certified Lover Boy. I mean, there are so many artists out there. Drake would have decided to feature them, but he said, no, I'll feature Thames on this track, Fountains. And Rihanna just met her. Like, wow, they were jubilating, celebrating. Just watch a video clip of Rihanna and Thames in the United States of America, cashing cruise. Thames don't blow. That is a huge one. We hope one day Rihanna will feature Thames in one of her songs. We can't wait for that. We can't wait for that. Yeah, we've known Riri, bad girl Riri. She has been dropping hits. She's been doing very well. And Thames, our own very Thames, our sister, she has been doing very well too. She's been, I mean, dropping hits and breaking records. So regarding Thames, we have this good news that Thames surpassed Yemi Alade and is now the second most streamed female Afrobeat artist of all time on Spotify, just behind Tiwa Savage. Just behind Tiwa Savage, she's now number two. Thames is blowing. Thames don't blow already. I mean, she has blown. That is the next. She just did a hit song with Wizkid, Essence. That song is the hottest song of Wizkid's album Made in Lagos. No doubt about that. She did, I mean, a super song too with Drake of his album Certified Lover Boy, Fountains. And now we see Thames with Rihanna. And when she was performing in the United States of America, because she just released her EP recently, I mean, people were vibing, singing to her song, like as if, man, Thames is not just a national star. She is now an international star. Congratulations to you, Thames. Keep rising. We hope one day you'll bring the Grammy home, just like Burna Boy. We really want the Grammy to come home, because we're doing very well. This is the only thing that gives us smile in this country, because the politicians are not giving us smiles. Nigerian names, I mean, we have this bad image outside. But fine, our entertainment industry, the Nollywood, they are doing superb job. And now the Afrobeats, I mean, group, they are doing very well. Fela did very well, no doubt about that. I mean, musicians have been doing very well in this country, and our actors and actresses have been doing very well. Kudos to all of them. I mean, they've been polishing Nigeria's image on the world map, because we have this dented image. yeah, our politicians are not really giving us the vibe. They are not giving us what we expect from them. Thank you very much for watching Jugglings Entertainment. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like, so to stay updated whenever I upload new content. Take care of yourself, and please do have a lovely day.